Boy, it's the first of the month. It's cray cray crazy around here. Oh my goodness. But I'm so happy that you're hanging out with me today. This is Ann Klimmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com. Hey, let's make some cards. So let's get started. Stamper, come. People, my people. Oh, I'm so happy to see you. Golly, I came in here. I even got the password wrong. How about that? Oh, yeah. Houston's in the house. Parker, Texas is in the house. Patty's in the house. Yeah. North Carolina. Florida. Yeah. Yeah. What did I do with Monday's card? I know I put it somewhere. Yeah, it's around somewhere. I know where it is. Sorry about that. You know, yeah, sorry about that. Oh, yeah. I've been busy, busy, busy. You know, we got a challenge out for our team. Oh, I'm so proud of them. Yeah, you know, you have a really big goal, then you have another goal that's still pretty nice, and they hit that. Yep, I'm so proud of my 24/7 stampers. Yeah. Not so proud of me right now. Yeah. Oh, my goodness, Patty. Yes, our hearts go out to all of you who are having issues. And those of you without power, I don't think you're watching. Yeah, and that's okay. We're still thinking of you. I was going to put, thank you. I was going to put something in the newsletter today, and then I didn't. Yeah, let me get a fan on here because I was rushing. I mean, my husband was getting my clothes out for me. How about that? He's so helpful. Because I could have shown up here naked. I mean, I don't think the back of my hair is dry. Oh, golly. And I have no excuse other than, you know, I mean, I don't know the last time I went out of the house. It's been at least a week, but I am going out tomorrow. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, there's just so many stories of what people are going through and having to relocate and stuff. And, you know, our hearts go out to you. But it's a new month and things have nowhere to go but up sometimes. Yep. So let's look at Monday's card because I did change it just a little bit. I added this and it would do, we all decided, we all agreed that it would look fine without it, but I just went, you know, I've got those, I think they're inspired thoughts. Yes, I got those inspired thoughts and I went, yeah. And I thought that would be really nice for somebody who is, you know, maybe they're facing a big challenge right now. So, what colors do you like for fall? Thank you, Marcy. Yeah, what colors do you like for fall? Like, if you're going to do some leaves, and we're going to do some leaves. Oh, by the way, Kay, did you get my email? Because those of you who shop with me and use the shopping code, right? Well, if you shop with me online, you're going to get a really nice thank you card. And I think I forgot to mention that the greeting was done with the free set that you can get with a $300 order, right? Well, you're also, if you use the code, you're going to get a sampling of these. And these are my favorites. These are my favorites. Yes, 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 yes. And I have to tell, okay, so back to this. What are your colors for fall? And, you know, I picked out white. And maybe I think I should do vanilla. This is good enough. This is big enough. That's fine. Cherry cobbler, crushed curry, and mossy meadow. You know, Deb, I'm just going to warn you, if you're new here, Deb always is the first one up with the colors. Yeah. Yeah, she's always up. Okay, so. Woo! Cherry cobbler, mossy meadow. crushed crate. You know, that is a pretty good, little. Yeah, I think I can work with this. But oh, an old olive. Yeah. Okay. Huh. You know what? Old olive might work better in this case. And I might switch this out to Cajun Craze instead of there. Hey, okay. Okay, pumpkin pie. Yeah, and we got to get some pumpkin pie in there, I think. Yeah, yeah. You think if we use this, should we use pumpkin pie or should I throw this back in? Yeah, maybe that's the thing. Yeah. Okay, because I'm just going to do a little brushing here. Oh, yeah, and soft suede is going to be great for the... This I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait on this because we may go with mossy meadow and we may not, you know. I have no idea. Don't tell anybody. Because when I say we're going to do real stamping, we are going to do real stamping. You know what? And there's something I wanted to share with you today. And let me see if I can bring this in because this is really going to... This is pretty much going to say how it is. And I don't, if I shared this with you before, well, then it's okay to say it. Say it today. Yep. It's okay to say it today because we are, oh, Blackberry Bliss. Oh, y'all are just making it right. Oh, you're just, yeah, too much like right. Okay. So I think that'll work for that. So when I do these brushes, I, you know, are you okay with that saying? Cause yeah. Okay. I gotta tell you, I'm in a small group, right? I'm in a small group of people who do what I do, but they don't do it the way I do it because they do live streams and we're always trying to hone our craft and, you know, yeah. Would you believe I studied for this? Anyway, we're trying to hone our craft and bring a better production to you. And yeah, if somebody calls this a production, they're highly overrating it, right? Anyway, but we're supposed to go and take a picture of what you see and then what I see. I think that would scare you too much. Hi, Kathy, how you doing? Okay, so that could scare you, especially those of you who are really, really organized. Yeah, because you'd be going, oh my goodness. Yeah, and those of you who are really, really, well, no, not really, really organized, but just fairly organized, I need you to come over and help me, okay? Okay, I'm looking. I'm looking to see. Well, I don't think this pink's going to work. And these are the blending brushes. And see, that would work if we go down that blackberry. Okay, I don't have a green one. I thought I had, I didn't think that far. Hi, Pop, how you doing? I know I have some brushes around here. I know I have some, you know, like never used before brushes. Yeah, the blushes, yeah. I'm gonna like cross that one over, okay, to that. Okay, good. Oh, here I have a green. That's, oh, look at that, looks like it's the same color. Yeah, we'll go that way. Okay, so we're gonna make, do I ever wash the blending brushes? What, you know, I don't clean my stamp room, so I think they washing my blending brushes is just asking a bit much there, Marcy. No, yeah, and here, everybody has a different value system, and you have yours, and everybody has their own, and so I'm throwing this out here in that kind of idea, right? I'm throwing this out here, you know, with that in mind, that you might go, oh, she is so nuts, and I'd be going, thank you, right? Anyway, so some people, use their little sponge daubers, right? And they wash them out and then use them again. And for me, I just kind of dedicate them to a stamp pad. And then when they get old and they start to kind of fall apart, then I just throw them away, right? It's just how I, because for me, I can make more money. I can't make more time. And I know that's hard if you're on a really strict budget, but yeah. Anyway, so if you wash them out and reuse them, you know, and do it that way, more power to you. That's great. I mean, because actually, if you wanted to, let's say, I want to change this. Yeah, let's say they don't do crushed curry anymore, and I want to go and do a new color. You could actually rinse this out. It would take a long time and a lot of water, which California doesn't have right now, right? And you could go in and just get all the color out of it and then get a re-inker, and it'd probably take almost the whole re-inker, and go re-ink it with a new color. So you can do that. I don't like messy things. So there's your answer. If you, these are so fine, right? These are so fine. They're very fine, you know, yeah. That I'm afraid that I would mess up the tip. Yeah. Did I get my lipstick on straight? Because it was like 30 seconds before we went. Yeah. So, yeah, there is no rhyme or reason. And I'm going to like, oh, yeah, I don't, we'll see how that looks, right? I'm just pouncing it. Oh, you're not looking. There, I'll do another one like that. Yeah, and that doesn't mean that there isn't, you know, there's people who throw away the edges of their dimensionals, but we talked about that on Monday, right? Okay. That's not going to matter that that's not even. But hold on one second. I think that I need to, maybe I do need a little bit more, because we're going to, ooh, yeah. See, look at, do not, you're not supposed to start. You're supposed to start over here and go in. Okay, well, I'm over it. I but I don't really care, right? I think I'm going to have to get more. I don't care that it's not even, because look what I'm going to do. Look what I'm going to do. Yes, we have someone in the house wants to make sure that you know that coming up Saturday, we are going to be having a used stamp sale. And I've got some papers that I didn't go and sell. You know, I didn't get rid of. Well, I didn't rehome. Let's call it that way. That I didn't rehome last month. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm going to go over here and get some more. Vanilla while you're not looking. Oh, golly, it's a whole half sheet. Oh, no, that's not. It's going to be a quarter sheet in a minute. I think it's one that I scored, and I must have scored it wrong. Wouldn't be the first time. There's a reason I do not score things for my classes, which, by the way, coming up soon, and I have an idea of what day it's going to be, but I'm not sure. So I've selected three of my favorite demonstrators, and it's not all of my favorite demonstrators, so don't be thinking that. Anyway, and we're going to be doing an online stamp camp. And, you know, do you think that that would be something that you'd be interested in? You know, where, and if we did it, because, you know, we're just getting started with this now here. Oh, okay. We're just testing here because Ann doesn't know what we're going to make. Ah, it's Friday, not Saturday. What said Saturday? Oh, Deb, not Debbie. Deb said Saturday. No, not Saturday. No. Okay. You should really, I would say, start with the lighter color. So I should have started with something like crushed curry. I just want to see how this is going to work. Yay. Okay. And we would have it to where, I think I'm going to start over here. And here, I can do this too. This is what's nice about this. You could go and do lots of things. But we're just doing testing. So if you think I'm going to, there's a card design, like a layout in my head. If we get there, great. See, look at that's more smooth because I was paying more attention. See? So, yeah. Okay, hold on 1 second. Oh, golly. Okay, now look how ugly that is. That is ugly, 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 right? We're going to make it pretty. I hope we're going to make it pretty, or maybe you're going to be wondering, Jack, should he do this for a living? Oh, yeah. First of the month is a challenge for me because there's a lot of things I need to get done at the end of the month. And then there's things I want to have for our online stamp club the first of the month. Yeah. And I wanted to do something with baby wipes, but guess what? I think my baby wipes are dry. Yeah. So this is the gorgeous leaves, right? We're going to try something else here. Hold on. But this bad boy, you know, hold on. It's hard when he goes, takes a nap. Yeah, baby. This could help. You might know where we're going with this, and maybe you don't. That's okay. Thank you. What color freckles? I don't know if we want freckles on that, but maybe we do. This could be very interesting. I'm gonna go for crumb cake. Yes, the brushes are great. This is just a bunch of stuff. Okay, hold on. To be on the safe side, I'm gonna go and stamp this off because I can always add, yeah, I think that's better. This is crumb cake. So this is stuff that's going to, you know, maybe it's going to inspire you, or maybe you're going to go, well, no, I'm not going to do that. Yeah. You have to think really hard when you're doing that stamping off thing on something like that, because you're going, okay, off stamp, because you're used to going like this, right? So anyway, okay, so if you were going to go to a stamp camp or a class about one stamp set or bundle in the holiday catalog. I call it the holiday catalog because it's about the holidays, right? Which stamp set, which bundle would it be? Would it be the penguins? Would it be, what do you think would it be? This is going to be way different than that one in gold. And I think I need to do it this way because there's more dark, or maybe not. Maybe the dark is down here. Oh, I've got to do this now. And then we're going to take this. Oh, golly. The dog. I don't know how you're going to see this. Let me see. Yeah, look at what that dog is doing. He's been doing it because my husband washed all his beds. Yeah, he washed all his beds, and that's how it happened. Yep. Nope, I think this has to go. I'm figuring this out. Now, no one's really given me a giving me an idea of what they would want to. Oh, the cabin set. Okay. Miss Amanda says the cabin set. Okay, he's done cleaning that now. Okay, so we're going to run this through like this, which means I'm going to do it on the big machine, right? So let me go and let's see how these turn out. Are you excited? Now, I'm going to tell you, Barbara told me a little secret today, and you can go and look and tell me if you think it's right. She said that when they showed the time-worn type in the catalog, that the picture is upside down. Now you're all going to run to it, right? By the way, hey, if you think that this, I'm having fun here, yes, I am, but it's all your fault, right? So anyway, we've got a special just this month, and so there's only, because some people took advantage of it in August, but now we only have this month left. Okay, everybody keep your fingers crossed and your hands in the prayer position, because I am committing here. Oh yeah, hold on. Where am I? Okay, all I have is the wax paper. Where am I putting the... We're okay. Okay. So anyway, if you want to join my team, yeah, I have a great team. You like me, boy, you'll love them. Anyway. Hey, here we go. So Karen, who really gets a vote in this, says merriest moments. I was just looking at that. I don't have it yet. It's next on my list, right? And then by the way, the dog is turning 16 tomorrow, which reminds me, I have a card. I better get him. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. So Kay said Nature's Harvest. Okay. And Deb said Peaceful Cabin or Beauty of Tomorrow. And then Miss Amanda said, oh, the bobble set. Y'all are saying all the stuff I didn't get yet. And I do mean yet. Oh, golly. I have something else. Yeah. So yeah. So the dog, I have, yeah. And hold on before I go there, Marcy, where am I supposed to put this? You think I know everything, right? I know you wrote it down on, I should put it on the top, right next to the, on the top of the paper, on the top of the cardstock, in between the cardstock and the die. That's what I'm going to do, unless you write it really quick. But anyway, this is how we're going to go and celebrate his birthday. It's going to be on the 16th because he's turning 16, right? And so we're going to have our hello, mystery card party. Yeah. And if you've never done it, you need to do it. Yeah. Good people show up. Even the people. Yeah. And some of them are on this. Yep. Okay. I'm sure I got this right. I just don't, you know, I know more than I do. Okay. Now I just put this through once. We'll see how it works. Okay, I didn't yet. I don't have the, yeah, that's where I had it. Okay, very good. Don't have a dryer. If I have a dryer sheet in here, you know, yeah. I just put this through once. We'll see how it goes. I think that's going to help. Wax them up. Yeah. In a perfect world, I would have put design, what do you call it? Adhesive sheets underneath here, but I didn't. Look at it. I was going to say it makes it all shiny, right? But it doesn't make it shiny. That's just it sitting there. And yes, I probably should have gone and run the brush over it first while the dye was on there. Oh, golly, you could just leave it like this with that on there. I mean, look at. And we're going to fix up this part. I knew that going in. Actually, it's wanting to pop out. So when I say real stamping, I mean like we are just up here trying new things, just as if you were here with me, except for you don't see the things I don't show everybody. People who even live here are like going, what's back in that room? What's back in that room? Come off. This isn't bad considering I haven't brushed it or anything. Probably helped it a little bit. If I would have gone over it with the brush, it would have been even, but I really wouldn't even care if it was like that because it looks kind of unique. I don't know. Maybe you like it, maybe you don't. Because what you could do, you know, you could put some like Winkostella on it. You could leave the wax paper on there. Yeah. I'll finish that out. But look at how it looks. Send all the pieces with it. Surprise puzzle. Yeah, okay. I like this, Miss Amanda. So anyway, isn't that great? It's just different. And what we would do, what I would do. Yeah, I'm sorry. I did not clean this up since the last project that I did. So it's kind of, you know how it is. You start with a great big clean area and then well here you can see it's very small. Oh, great tidings. Oh yeah, the thing about the penguins, what I thought was because, you know, I don't want to say, because you know when people say all or every or you know, it's usually not true, right? But like when I get Stamp Club going and stuff, well, they might start out not having a big shot or a cut and emboss machine, you know, or some kind of die cutting machine, but they end up with it. Just ask Cheryl. She got her mini cut and emboss machine for free. I'm like, free or awfully cheap. Okay. I'm looking for a, oh golly, I think it's, Barbara needs to come back. Because Barbara went and did all this for me and see, look at it, it's got soft sky in there. That's kind of old. That's kind of, yeah, dated. I know I have one here. Yep, that'll do. The problem with cleaning my stamp room is because if I do, then I get ideas on things to make, and then I start making them, and then we never finish. Oh, see, that's kind of dark. Whoa, that's kind of dark. There you go. Wow, that's because this had a lot of ink on it. Yeah, and it wasn't black ink. It's green, but I had just re-inked it and I forgot. What happens then? Just get here, let's see. Yeah, Kay says she always does her intricate dyes upside down. She's probably right. Because I do that every now and then. When I think of Kay. But in any case, yeah, that would work. Okay, so here's how these worked out. Dryer sheet. You're assuming I do laundry. I do have some dryer sheets in here. They're in one of the drawers. Yeah, here's my sister from another mister, right? This shouldn't take long. Hold on, that shouldn't take long. See, look at, well, here I was saying, yeah, it has to be, you know, darker than that. You'd think that it was going to be darker because, I mean, wait till we do the green one because that was awfully dark. And you don't want this. Did I take that off? I don't know. My glasses don't work up close. That looks like it's got, no, here it is. See, look what I already did. Look how light that is. But it looked really dark, but that's okay because I can fix it. I can bend it to my will. Yeah. Where'd that pumpkin pie go? Okay, let's see how the green one turned out. Yeah, sometimes we finish the whole card here. Sometimes we just do parts of it, you know, because the main thing is that you go make a card. It, you know, what I do here pales in significance to what you do. If I can inspire you to go and make a card, look at, you're going to bless somebody else. You're going to get blessed because you went and, you know, you're going to feel good about yourself because you made someone a card. But I'm going to tell you, I read something today, and don't get hung up on the reaction. If they like it, they don't like it. If they threw it away because they didn't realize that it was so good that they didn't realize that you made it, right? Or the dog got it. Yeah, that happened here once. Yeah, I have a picture of him. He was in puppy jail and he had torn a card apart. Yeah. Right after we did the video. Thanks a lot, bud. Yeah, he doesn't get up to that so much now. But see, look at, remember how dark that was? Now it only has just a little bit of dark on there. What color should we add to that to make it darker? I'm staying away from this mossy meadow because that, maybe we should put a little bit of the soft suede because somebody I know brought that up. What color should we do? I'm amazed at how light these are because I thought I was doing it pretty dark. So what does that mean? That you should go and maybe start with, rather than this, maybe start with crumb cake. Oh, I'm gonna have to vacuum. I could still take some of this. I could. Cajun craze, okay. Not the red, because I've got the red here. Cherry cobbler is very similar. Very similar. It's not quite so orangey. And look at, I'm not even blending it. I'm just kind of... There you go. Yeah, see, look at, it's just, I don't know. I think a lot of it is, hold on one second. I know I have this color out. Yeah, there it is. See how it's going to change it. That's Cajun Craze. See, it makes this pop. That's for sure. There's the Cajun Craze. See, and we didn't even use Cajun Craze. Got another one here. Ooh, boy. When I picked this one up, everything came out. Wax paper always makes me think of my mom. Because this time, you know, coming into the fall, she made the best popcorn balls and she put red dye in it, which is probably why I'm the way I am. Because red dye's not supposed to be good for you, right? Oh, yeah, he's okay with that bed, but he doesn't come in here when I'm not here. He's okay with that bed because it beats sitting on the floor. Okay, so yeah, I actually like this one that has a lot of pumpkin pie on it. And maybe we could put some pumpkin pie on that. And maybe. Okay, now let's see what it looks like on here. This is cinnamon cider. It speaks to me, but not quite as much. It really looks best, don't you think? I think it really looks best on the Cajun Craze. And we did not put any Cajun Craze on there. Yeah. Okay, when you say that, okay, are you saying that we should not have had that red dye that we grew up with, or that one was okay and the new stuff's not good? I think I know what you're gonna say. So here's what I'm going with. It's in my head. It's not all the way in my head. That's the hard part. I think this should be the base. Yeah, Cajun Craze gets my vote too. And I don't even think we need this. This is, I don't know. Maybe I'll put a little bit of, no, I was going to put orange, I was going to put pumpkin pie on that, wasn't I? And we didn't even do a big one. We didn't even do, and here I've got all this here, so. Let's go with the light to dark. We're going to put some pumpkin pie on this. Yeah. If I can just remember where I put everything. Well, we're not putting that color. We might. I don't know. I know pumpkin pie is out, but it's like going, okay, cherry cobbler, mossy meadow. We never did use the soft suede. You know how it is where I can put something down and then it's like, where'd it go? I don't know. And I had pumpkin pie out. Here's crumb cake. Here's old olive. There it is. There it is. Yeah. Okay, but we're going to start off with. Crushed curry. Oh, and Clemmer. Okay. I think I did this. I hope you're talking about that dye and not about the fact that you don't like the leaves. So you can do it both ways. If you want to have it be, you know, all spotty and stuff, then, you know, do this thing. Do this thing. Yeah, right? Do it. Okay, this is pumpkin pie. Pumpkin pie. So you should, like, rub it off in between. Yeah. Gonna put a little bit of that on there. Not a lot, not a lot. That's pumpkin pie. I want pumpkin pie down here. Yeah. Yeah, in between colors, definitely go in. I don't know that about washing out. Oh, you can't see him, but I'm doing this down at the bottom. There you go. Yeah. And then look at those little dots. They just show up a little bit. It's really subtle because I wanted it to look freckled. You know, I could put a little bit more on that. There's no law saying that just because this is like this that I can't like add some here. So I'll try this for you, right? And I'm bouncing it because I don't want to rub it because you know it's gonna, oh, hello, you're not looking. Sorry. You know that if you rub this, it's going to go and pick up the, it's gonna pick up some of those pieces and bend them and just like you don't want them to do. So I'm just bouncing it right around the edge. And where I want it to be lighter is here and a little bit up there so that it looks like the light's coming from here. Oh, I like it better already. It still looks different. Not sure about that. I'm sure some kind of hose somewhere. Yeah. Here, let me go in. Now the green, let's see where we're going with that. I'm just gonna try for old olive this time, I think. Only because that mossy meadow was so dark. Oh, so, whoa! Yeah, no. I tried to bounce it just a little bit. Yeah, it's got a lot on there. Oh, see, I'm going for this. I think that'll work. But I think it needs... a little cherry cobbler. Who would have thought we'd be doing this today? And that might be some of the leftover, I think... Okay, when's the next last time? I bet you all go and rub your brushes, right? Yeah, you haven't been bouncing them, have you? You know I'm going to be doing something different. I think that probably has I was like, wow, that's putting a more of a pumpkin color because that's what color was on it. Yeah, okay. I want more red, and especially out here. I am not doing a blending thing. I don't want it to be blended. Yeah, okay. Anybody interested to see what this one looks like? I think this is gonna look pretty sweet. I think so. We're gonna try it without the wax paper, see if it makes any difference, right? Yeah. So on Friday, you wanna be here at 5 o'clock, cause that's when we have our big sale. There's going to be all kind of thing. I'm going to tell you something that is not in there, and that is that hope set. You know, I almost got more of those. Now I'm going to tell you, I did put this through twice. Look how light it looks. It looks so light. There are no, and it's, yeah, I put it through twice and put it through and then I came around and put it through again. These are coming out really easy. I guess it just depends on the dye. I mean, look at those came out. Boom, 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 done. But look at that. It's like looks so light. It doesn't look like this one is stuck. It says, I'm not moving. Yeah, it needs a little bit more. It needs to be beat up some more. No, I think it's because I think that the reason why they're looking paler is because when it's kind of like that thing, it just came to me. You know, when you buy a carpet, right? When you buy a car, if you've ever gone shopping for carpet, how it looks when you're looking on the roll is one thing. And when you're looking at a carpet sample, it's one thing. And then when you go and have it installed, it always looks lighter. So I do remember that, especially when they brought the wrong carpet over. They weren't real happy about that. So I'm thinking that it has to do with that we're looking at it one way when it's a whole mishmash of color. And then when you just bring it out like this, it really is the true color. And so, but the good thing about that is you would want it to go that way rather than come in too dark, because you can always, that's just a little bit more red. Kids today wouldn't know what a clothesline or a clothespin would. My daughter would, because when we lived in England, they do a lot of that. Gonna make this darker. So I'm gonna kind of tell you what it's gonna look like, and then go and check it out tomorrow on the dog's blog, because I promise I will finish this up. But get ready, because I want you to give me some ideas, you know, because I'm not like married to them or anything like that. You know, we're not getting custodial stuff. So if I do this and I put this on here like this, and maybe have a little bit of gold around there, right? And then we can put our little pumpkin here, and then I'll bring out the shape. And I'm not guaranteeing this, because, you know, I start making it, and then all of a sudden, no, not that. Kay, did you get this one? Tailor-made dies? Yeah. No, it's not that. It's the seasonal dies. Yeah. Okay. So I could, nope, that's too big. Put a little greeting here. Nope, they're too small. Maybe this be just right, right? Yeah. Well, now you know, Beverly. Do you know what? When we bought the carpet that's here in this stamp room, because in this room, we're going to have to move for them to take this carpet out, because it's too hard. I don't even know if I could get my desks out of here without disassembling them. I think it's this way. Like that. I'm not sure. Anyway, my friend said, stay away from that pinky beige. And then what did I get? The pinky beige. Yeah. Oh. Look at this. Yeah, have a little bit of that on there. And then maybe just attach a few of these little bad boys. And this would be vanilla, right? Yeah. And of course, we put a little bit of time-worn type. And then look at, you only have to stamp a little bit right there. So go and tune in. Go and check out the dog's blog tomorrow. And you know, hey, and while you're there, make sure you go and, well, you'll get a pop-up that asks you if you want to be on our mailing list. And I highly recommend it. Yeah, I highly recommend it, because we're going to be starting 12 Weeks Christmas Ideas soon. And yeah. Yeah. So, hey, what do you think about this layout? Before I go on, you know, before I go and put this together. This will be vanilla. This will be early espresso, probably. Bit of this and just a little bitty little thing here. This will be textured. Yeah, lots of texture on this and a little bit of gold around here. Kay says no, but I don't know what she's talking about. I don't think she's talking about this. And of course, you know, I could be coerced to take the rest of this little bit out because it wants to come out. Oh, well, Patty says yes. Or says, you know, you're going to have to come to my house and pry these parts from my cold dead hands. Oh, golly. YouTube's going to come and get me. They're going to say, what are you talking about? Hey, we are praying for all those who have gone through some bad times lately. And there's a lot of bad times going. But just know that when you're coming here, we are just going to get silly. We're going to get wild. I like it even better now. Look at, you can see more of the little dots. Just the little dots. Just enough to go in. Yeah. Got it. Oh, yeah. Okay. No, you don't have the dyes. Got it. And I might like add a little bit more red to these and so that it pops more, but I think that's pretty much it. And then, but boy, if I put some of that gold, let's see. The rose gold might be good. Look at, okay. Just a little subtle. Yeah. So yeah, there's a bit of an idea. I'm just so glad that you hung out with us today. Let me, leave you with the words of William Shakespeare. A light heart lives long. So live long and prosper, everyone. I will see you back here Friday, 5 o'clock for our big sale. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun
yes
into your day. See you Friday, 5 o'clock. Get ready for a good time.